Oh, hey everyone, it's Justin again. Mia and I made it to the final stop of our road trip, the Grand Canyon. The view from the top of the canyon is breathtaking. We got a permit to hike down into the canyon and camp along the riverbank. The average depth of the canyon is over 6,000 feet. Park rangers say it's doable in one day, but we're gonna break up the hike into 5 equal sections. We can use our long division skills to help us plan our hike. By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to represent remainders as fractions. Check if a quotient for a division problem is reasonable by using multiplication, and find and fix mistakes in a division problem. Have your guided notes ready, and let's hit the trail. The canyon is 6,093 feet deep. We'll break the descent into 5 equal sections so we can stop and take a breather as we hike. Following the long division steps, we'll divide, multiply, subtract, bring down, and repeat. First, we'll check how many times 5 fits into 6. It fits once. 1 times 5 equals 5, and we'll subtract 6 minus 5. That equals 1. Then we bring down the next digit of the quotient, which is 0. Pause the video here and repeat the steps of the long division algorithm to finish solving 6,093 divided by 5. Record your thinking in your guided notes. By repeating the steps, we should have a whole number quotient of 1,218 and a remainder of 3. But how will we include the remainder of 3, though? Does that mean that one or more of the sections of our hike has to be longer? It could mean that one section will have 3 extra feet to hike, or that 3 of the sections will each have 1 extra foot to hike. But me and I would prefer to split the 3 extra feet equally among the 5 sections. So instead of recording the remainder as R3, we can turn it into a fraction. Check it out. We have 5 groups to equally split the 3 extra feet into. Since there are 5 groups, we can split each of the extra 3 into 5 pieces, or fifths. Each of the pieces represents 1/5 of the whole. Then we can start spreading out the fractional pieces. 1/5 to the first section, another 1/5 to the second section, 1 to the third section, 1 to the fourth section, and finally the last piece to the 5th section of the hike. Repeat that with the 5ths from the other 2 pieces we had left over. Now, each section of the hike has 1, 2, 3/5 of a foot in addition to the 1,218 whole feet that we'll hike. By writing the remainder as a fraction, we're sharing those 3 extra feet equally across all 5 sections. This means that we'll hike a total of 1,218 and 3/5 feet in each of the 5 sections of our hike. Luckily, 3/5 of a foot only adds a few steps to each section of the hike. What do you notice about the fraction 3/5 and how it relates to the other numbers of this division problem? Pause the video here to record your thinking. The numerator of 3/5 is the same as the remainder 3, or the leftover amount we're working with. And the denominator is the same as the divisor, 5. That's because the denominator of a fraction tells us how many pieces a whole is split into. And the divisor of a division problem also tells us how many groups or pieces to split the whole into. So remainders can be represented as fractions by using the remainder as the numerator and the divisor as the denominator. Since this is gonna be such a long hike, we should really make sure that our answer is correct before we set out. How do you think we can check the answer to a division problem? What operation is the inverse or opposite of division? Multiplication. Just like with our basic division facts, we can check long division using multiplication. Here's how it works. We'll multiply our whole number quotient times the divisor, so 1,218 times 5. Pause the video here to solve and record your thinking. I used the multiplication algorithm to solve 5 times 1,218, and I got a product of 6,090. But that isn't the same as the dividend we started with. Oh yeah, we still have our remainder to use. How do you think we'll use our remainder of 3 to finish checking our work? Well, 6,090 plus 3 equals 6,093. And that's the dividend we started with. Nice job. Here's another example to practice representing a remainder as a fraction and checking our work using multiplication. Mia divided 3,279 by 7 and got a quotient of 467, remainder 10. Let's check out our work. Huh. There aren't any more digits of the dividend to bring down, but we should be able to take another group of 7 out of 10. The remainder can't be larger than the divisor, right? So that means Mia must have made an error in her work somewhere. Pause the video here to check the steps of Mia's division and identify the error. Then solve the division problem yourself, representing the remainder as a fraction, and then check your answer using multiplication. All right, let's go through it step by step. 7 does fit into 32 4 times. 32 minus 28 equals 4. She brought down the 7 correctly. 7 fits into 47 6 times. And 47 minus 42 does equal 5. And the 9 was brought down. Ah, here's the error. 7 fits into 59 8 times instead of only 7 times. So the last step should be 59 minus 56, which will equal a remainder of 3. How can we represent the remainder 3 as a fraction? 3 will be the numerator. And what will the denominator be? We use the divisor, so 7. That gives us the fraction 3 sevenths. I use partial products to check my answer by expanding 468 into 400 plus 60 plus 8. And then multiplying each part by 7. Once I had my answers, I added them together, and I got a product of 3,276. Finally, I added that remainder of 3, and got my final answer, 3,279, just like the dividend we started with. Using multiplication to check your work is a great strategy if you aren't sure of your answer, if your remainder is larger than your divisor, or if you just want to make sure your answer is reasonable. Whew! We made it to the bottom of the Grand Canyon, and it's time to set up camp by the riverbank. I think Mia and I have earned some rest after that trek. So, what have we learned today, besides the fact that long hikes are better with friends? Well, now you know that a remainder can be represented as a fraction. You also know that quotients can be checked by using multiplication. And you know how to find and fix mistakes in long division problems. Be sure to complete the practice questions and extension activities that go with this lesson to practice representing remainders as fractions, checking your work with multiplication, and identifying errors in long division. Mathematicians, our next lesson is the long division unit wrap-up lesson. There won't be a video, but there will be practice levels to review everything you've learned throughout the unit. There's also an extension activity in the wrap-up lesson to help you reflect on your progress and decide if there are any lessons you'd like to revisit before the unit assessment. That's because in math, as in life, every effort adds to your success. I'll see you again in our next unit. Hey.